the antiretroviral drugs that are being used these days really are very, very effective. And if taken, almost everybody will achieve an undetectable viral load on those treatments.
So the most important aspect of PROMs for people living with HIV is, number one, that we're involved in the development of the PROMs on determining what the characteristics of the PROM should be and prioritizing the types of PROMs that are used in R&D trials.
Our ultimate goal is to make patients and people feel better. And therefore, it's important to measure a patient's perception of their health and quality of life, in addition to important clinical outcomes that might be good proxies for prognosis.
It's really important from the perspective of people living with HIV that when we're participating in trials, that the PROMs aren't too burdensome, that we're not being asked to fill out endless questionnaires for the sake of filling out endless questionnaires. They should have a particular role in determining specific outcomes that are important for people living with HIV.
It's important to realise that not everybody living with HIV is the same. There are people who, people who are women, people who are transgender, people who are Black African, for instance, and they may have some very different perspectives on what they see as an important patient-reported outcome.
So the importance of stakeholders in this project is paramount because we need to make sure that different perspectives are brought to the table. And to date, we've had really good input from academia, from clinicians, from the pharmaceutical industry. It's been really, really good. Moving forward, though, we really do need to have the engagement of regulators in this process, because it's important that the regulators are involved in helping to determine which kinds of PROMs are used in HIV R&D.
Today, things are a little bit different as the vast majority of treatments are highly effective and well tolerated. It's nevertheless still relevant to ensure that experimental products are not inferior to existing ones, both in terms of course, safety and efficacy, but also in terms of their impact on quality of life.
Academia is really important when thinking about identifying new PROMs for R&D. We have the skills and the expertise really to develop those PROMs, but also to run studies that would allow us to validate the PROMs, make sure those PROMs are reliable and appropriate for the purpose that they're going to be used for.
I think there has to have been a common approach with the patient at the forefront to the development of these PROMs, so that we know that the values that we're measuring mean something to the patient.
So I think this is where academia really can help. And, you know, it's nice to be given an opportunity perhaps to work with our colleagues, not only from the community, but also from pharma, to think about how we can develop this list of PROMs that would be ideal for use within this trial setting.
You know, if it's a academic researcher or a clinical researcher or a pharmaceutical company, we've got to be round the table at the very beginning for this kind of research to mean anything, so that we all know what we want out of it and that we can come up with a common ground, a common agenda.